Soul Winner's Guide. As life seems to be ebbing away at every sunrise and sunset, we are reminded each day of the purpose of being alive, and taking that breath slowing as it comes with the force of drawing like a man, who have just finished a long distant race, whatever be the state of the mind in which you find yourself. The mind of the super busy, whose schedule is not appreciated by your loved ones, or the lonely or alone who feel unloved, unfulfilled and non-useful. The quiet time to reflect what life is all about brings us always to a point of deep soberness and need of assurance that it's all worth it to still carry on and hope that all will be well at the end of it all. But the certainty that all will be well seems to slowly want to call out for help and say, "Can someone please come over this side and help me?" We are in a world full of ghastly hopelessness of a slow uncontrolled collision that has left many wounded and damaged. The need for attention is stretched beyond belief. No one is capable of standing either as the casualty or the helper. The situation is overwhelming. Any hand that is raised at the moment has to show its essence for attention. St. Paul in his outstanding missionary journey came to Troas and had a vision in Acts 16 verse 9, in which he saw someone making a fervent plea for him to come over to Macedonia and help us. Could that person in the vision be you? If given the opportunity to cry out physically without hiding behind a vision, a dream or a mask, will you be able to carry out for assistance when in dire straits? Like in the harvest in any agricultural area, the one that has hedged his barn well is the only one to sleep when the storm is coming. However, if you are at risk of being wiped out in the storm, will you be silent and watch your hard work evaporate with the storm? Many years as a young boy, my young friend who was being persecuted by his parents for being a Christian, urged me to give my life to Christ. That singular act of faith has helped me through the years as a student, a youth leader, a church coordinator to present the need for souls to be banked for the Lord. That has brought about this day to be a day of great joy in presenting the gamified structure for soul winning. The aspect of moving from my quest for answers to action is of great essence as a man in need of the grace that is only obtainable by yielding my way to God. Having that undertone of knowledge that I am lost and in need of the grace or love of the Almighty. That only and only in Christ is the solution found for my sin. Like using the antidote from an animal that causes a sickness to formulate a cure. We as man formulate the sin, then Christ came as man to provide the antidote for sin. Then in this journey the need to get the point of knowing that Christ is the all-sufficient Savior from sin. The willingness to jettison the things of the flesh is of great essence. A despondent man who feels lost in the busy world of life without courage. The wonderful gift from the Lord who came to seek and to save. Jesus said, "Without him you can do nothing." To experience the saving knowledge of Christ is of great essence. That is the main thing. As a signpost in pointing you to the love of Christ. Remember that one day you will be the signpost for others to follow. You must be clear and readable. To make a meaning. A soul winner's must. 1. Committed his or her life to Christ. 2. Be a good signpost for the gospel with his or her life. 3. Accept that man needs the word of God because he is lost. 4. Accept that Jesus Christ is the only Savior from sin. 5. Believe in prayer and in the power of the Word of God to save. 6. Submit to the leading of the Holy Spirit. The best thing ever known to man by God is to win souls. Jesus said he came to seek and save, and without him we can do nothing. In the area of soul winning, you must be born again. So Jesus said to Nicodemus as a prerequisite to getting into the kingdom of God. The experience is infectious. When you get it, anyone who is around you will catch it and also get born again. When preaching the gospel, you make your life to become a city on the hill. You'll be watched. I once remember I asked some people in our congregation to get ready for evangelism and tract sharing. When one of us said he can't go for evangelism to his street because he just quarreled with his neighbor and will not want to see him carrying a Bible. The psalmist said, "Create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me." This is the essence of the gospel of soul winning.